so far away.
Alright, so we've had some problems with the F100 wanting to start here of late. I just pulled the carburetor apart, took the top off to see what our bowls look like, because every morning here lately, it just does not want to start. Now this morning, I'm sure, even though it's like 40 degrees out, it'll probably start right up because I just took the lid off the carburetor. But that's what it's doing here lately. It's taking a lot more time for it to saw up and actually get the thing to start. I know the choke's not set right because it's idling too low, but that's not the bigger issue here. Now, a while back, we told you guys that we were gonna go in and actually do a plug check on this thing, and that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna look at what's going on with the carburetor, and we're gonna check the plugs to see how they are. So, as it tries to die, I'm going to back it out. I don't know how this is going to work with it being this cold. It's running really rich. It's throwing out additional white smoke, which tells me that there is a lot of fuel seeping down into that carburetor. Such a long trip. Now to work. Oh, gotta put it in park first. It's the parking paw.
All right, so we know that it's running rich, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull a spark plug. Now when we got this truck, we put a new set of plugs, wires, everything in it. So this should be a decent guess at how it's running. Wow, that was still really tight. All right, get this to where it can thread easily. Ooh, she is a little bit dark. Not bad though, really not bad at all. It looks like it's got raw fuel on it. Also, there is a very thick film on the outside of the threads. Can you see that, Logan?
Yep.
Which, honestly, don't know what it smells like. It almost smells like PB Blaster, which should not be there. And not that thick anyway. But overall, the plug does not look horrible. It looks wet, but we were just dumping fuel down it. So it might use a little bit smaller jet, but honestly I wouldn't be hard pressed to run that at all. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull some more and keep on digging.
That's an interesting
substance.
That it's really cool looking. I mean, I kind of like the little massive amounts of stringies, but that really doesn't bode well for what's going on with probably the carburetor.
Yes, I say that is probably raw fuel that is pushed up through the threads, because it's not external, but you can see around every spark plug that has it thick, you can see a moisture ring around the spark plug itself.
So it's pushing fuel out. There's enough fuel being spent. It doesn't look like an oiling problem.
No, it doesn't smell like burnt oil. It doesn't even smell like anything. honestly feels like gasoline that's just been reduced and reduced and reduced.
Right.
Back to the old liquid dinosaurs that it is.
The tar pits. Yeah. Tar pits. So we got a problem here. We don't really know what's causing it. So far, all the plugs on the driver's side of the engine, you know, number 5 through 8, are nasty. We're looking at probably having to pull the rest of these. And we're going to take them out and clean them and see what we can get out of them.
Yeah.
But we have a carburetor issue here. We have another carburetor laying around that we might throw on this thing that is an Autolite. I also have a 750 that I could put on here. But I really don't want to put another carburetor on here until we can figure out what's wrong with this one, because we may end up with the same issues. We just don't know.
And this one runs perfectly.
And it runs fine. It's just getting really hard to start, and that we now...
Carburetor issues.
Now, if you're having a problem like this, one of the things you can run into is most of the time, if you're going to have these kind of leak down issues with fuel that's being percolated into the intake manifold, it's going to go to number 4 and number 8 on the engine. So those are the places that you're going to see the worst development of raw fuel or anything like that. Number 1 and number 5 typically aren't a big issue because these engines are slightly angled, so everything goes through the back of it. So Cam and I are going to go ahead and pull the plugs on the passenger side, get those out, take a look at them. But we already know we have a fueling problem.
Yeah.
Now I just need to figure out what that fueling problem is. So Cam, get a whip.
You mean do the work?
Yes. All right, now what we're going to do is I'm going to take my two best plugs, which were 1 and 2 on the passenger side, and we're going to move them to the two worst locations on the driver's side, which is 7 and 8. And what we're going to do is we're just going to leave these plugs in here for now and run it and see what we get. We are doing something wrong gasoline-wise. We don't have a power valve issue, I'm pretty sure, because the truck runs so clean. We don't have an issue with the accelerator pump because there's no leaking on the front of the bowl of the carburetor. So we've got to have some kind of other issue, and I'm going to have Cam talk to you about that in just a second. But meanwhile, I'm going to go ahead and get the plugs back in this bad boy so we can take it out for a test drive just to see what we end up with. Another thing I'll say about these plugs is when you get these plugs now, they are not gapped for a classic car. They are actually gapped for electronic ignition. So you want to check your plug gap on them and make sure you gap it to whatever your original specifications on your vehicle is. Otherwise, your gap's going to be too big, and if you got points on the car, it's not going to work right. So remember, if you have an electronic ignition, the gap will probably be okay. But if you have points on the car, you're going to need to change the gap on them.
All right, so we have theorized that part of our problem is actually fuel boil. What this is coming from is not actually the intake heat being transferred through the base of the carburetor. We are thinking that our filter base is actually trapping heat around the carburetor when it's just sitting there after a drive. So this is the bottom off of our Fairlane. This is a factory Ford. I believe these are 14-inch round filters. It doesn't have a riser or anything in it. It's just a regular 2-inch air filter. Now the one that we have here is the one that we've been running on the truck. Now this is actually off of a Camaro. It's made for a Holley 4-barrel, and you can see the cutouts for the fuel bowls there. We've been running this so that we can run a 3-inch air filter, and this clears the electric choke on our carburetor. But the dish is much deeper, and we're theorizing that it's actually holding and catching the heat from the engine, causing the fuel to boil and flow down into the intake and go into our cylinders. This could also be an issue with the stock air filters, as it's like a gigantic pancake above it that's just catching the heat and holding it. So we're going to put this one on there and take it for a drive. As you can see, there's not much of a dish, so hopefully it won't hold that much heat, and we'll see what it does afterwards.
Right, that's without any input from the accelerator pedal at all. It's running nice right now. I'm gonna take it out for a drive and see what we get. And yes, I do have an exhaust leak or 3. We'll be right back.
All right, now that Jeff has gotten back from driving, I'm going to use a temp gun to check the bowl temperature right as it sits. So we are right at 109, 106, 109 max. And because of TZ Magic, I've actually already done this and it was 98 degrees before in about 2 minutes of time frame. So we are definitely soaking up some heat. So I'm gonna let this down. And we are going to let this sit for a little bit and see what it gets up to.
All right, so we have a base problem, and that's something that you're gonna have to do. You have to worry through these issues. What's going on is when the vehicle sits, we're getting percolation off of the vents up on top. You can see possibly the little red dot. There's your vent on an Autolite 4100 and some of the 2100s as well. And what's going on is the fuel is getting really hot inside the bowl and is coming out through the vent up there on top. And there's not really a good way to get around this unless you go in and do something like what we're planning on doing, which is putting a phenolic spacer on the base underneath the carburetor. Now, I didn't want to go ahead and buy a spacer if I didn't need one yet, because I didn't know that that was it. We figured it might be something else. But sitting here with the air cleaner off and the hood open, I am smelling fuel pretty strongly, like if I had the gas cap open. So it's actually not just coming out of the front vent. It's not actually just coming out of this front vent. It's also coming out of the vent in the very back as well. So we know we have an issue with heat soak on this. Any carburetor is going to want to heat soak, especially if you're running ethanol fuels, because it's just going to vaporize a lot quicker than it would if it weren't. So there's two things that you can do. You can put a phenolic spacer on there, get the carburetor up a little higher off the intake manifold. You can get an aluminum intake manifold, which can go to reducing two things. It'll reduce weight, which these are like 98 pound intake manifolds, and it'll also reduce your heat load in soak off. The cast iron will hold on to it a lot longer than the aluminum will. The other thing you can do is probably the cheaper thing is to put the phenolic spacer and then possibly one of the carburetor plates, because on the Autolites, the power valve on the very front bottom of the carburetor is right there in the heat line. And I mean, it is the first thing that sees heat. So fuel will begin to push out, possibly through that power valve, I don't know, and then dropping into the intake manifold and causing the issues that we've been having with the truck. Everything runs entirely too nice for me to think there's any other carburetor problems at all. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna probably off camera work on this a little bit more, but you guys wanted to see this. Some guys had asked for it, so that's what's going on. So Cam's gonna come back in here, we're gonna finish this thing up. Cam, come in! Well, brother.
Problem is, she's hot.
I mean, she's hot, yeah, but too. Actually it's he. He's a hot.
Yeah, it's hot in the wrong spots.
He's hot in the wrong spots. That's gonna be something that we're gonna have to do later, because but we do know what the problem is. What I really wanted to do with this is just show guys that you can't just automatically say it's this.
Yeah.
Because with what it was starting to do, you know, a lot of guys would say, well, the carburetor's crap, let's just take the carburetor off.
Yep.
Carburetor runs great.
Yeah, if it's running fine, it's typically not a carburetor problem.
And that's what we had. We had a situation where it was running good.
Yep.
Carburetor really wasn't the issue, but what we kept smelling was gas.
Yep.
And so we know now that we've got a hot soak problem, that whenever the truck sits, it soaks. It's possibly puking fuel down into the engine right now, because we can still smell gas.
Yeah.
And it's been like 25 minutes.
And the bowls are still at about 150.
Yeah, they're still really warm. And I mean, with the cast iron intake,
it's going to be that way for a minute.
It will. And I mean, I don't know if this was a problem real bad back in the day, but I wonder if that's a fuel related issue too.
Yes. With ethanol, it evaporates much, much quicker.
It's going to have to be a new spacer. We're going to get probably a 1-inch, like I said. I'm not going to go in and all that. So we're at premium minutes. So now we're going to go in and make the changes. You know, and I guess we can report back. If you guys are interested in seeing what the outcome on this is, let us know. We may put a really small episode up saying, okay, we did this. It's made a difference. It's not heat soaking on us like it was. Because I got to believe anybody with a carburetor right now may be running into these same kind of issues on a vintage car that's running, you know, a four-barrel carburetor.
Yeah, and pretty much anything, especially springtime to summertime, you get a lot more heat soak issues. The ultimate fix for that's taking the hood off, though. Yeah, that's how I roll. No cooling problems. And it's easy access to fix it.
It's not the downstairs cooling, it's the cooling up up here I'm worried about.
Yeah, got a little bit burnt out early.
All right, folks, do me a favor and go out and subscribe to the channel. Click that bell for notification. If you don't click the bell, guess what? No, nothing. We don't even hear from us. It's like we're not even
there.
We're
dust in the wind.
Dust in the wind. Anyway, so do that. And then also check out our Patreon account. At the $10 a month level, you get monthly Zoom meetings with me. And we interact. It is not just me talking to you. We actually sit down and have long conversations. We're on there for about an hour to an hour and a half on one Sunday a month. So check it out. Do that if you want to. It supports the channel and you get something out of it as well because we do tech questions and all that kind of stuff. It is a lot of fun. And finally, be good to each other. Be kind to each other. Love on each other. You guys have a great week and we'll see you next time on
Autorestomod.
Like it farts every once in a while with gas.
That was just me.
Gas.
Oh.